I'm Marianne Hogan. I am the president at St. Vincent's Academy. And on behalf of the Sisters of Mercy, the administration, the faculty and staff, and the students, I would like to welcome you to our 52nd Christmas Candlelight Concert. Thank you so much for being here this evening. You will be delighted. Our students have truly the voices of angels. Before we begin, I would like to thank Monsignor Schreck, the rector of the Cathedral Basilica of St. John the Baptist, for allowing us to have the concert in this beautiful space. Please remember, this is a sacred space. Please make sure that you hold all applause until the end of the performance. Please do not leave your pews to take any photographs, and flash photography is very distracting to the performers. Thank you so very much to Mr. Ryan Beck, our chorus director, for his dedication, his love of music, and really for inspiring our girls to be closer to the Lord. We are so very proud of him and the work that the students have done to make this concert so very special. May God bless each of you during this season of Advent. May your Christmas be filled with love, joy, and peace. Please enjoy the concert.
The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise of blessings I have made to the house of Israel and to the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will call a righteous branch to spring up from the line of David. He will do what is just and upright in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved and Jerusalem will live in safety. This is the name which the city will be called. The Lord is our righteousness.
Shall come to thee, O Israel. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. And behold, your cousin Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And she who was called barren is now in her sixth month, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word."
As it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah, the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, "Prepare the way of the Lord."
Keep watch, for you do not know the day when your Lord will come.
Oh, tail as big as a kite, with a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, "Do you hear what I hear?
Hear what I hear?
Ringing through the
an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to receive Mary into your home as your wife, for this child has been conceived in her womb through the Holy Spirit. When Joseph rose from his sleep, he did what the angel of the Lord commanded him to do. He took Mary into his home as his wife.
While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
In the nearby countryside, there were shepherds living in the fields and keeping watch over their flock throughout the night. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terror-stricken, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy for all people. For this day, in the city of David, there has been born to you a Savior, who is Christ, the Lord."
Oh, stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and never pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its word. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder
The wise men set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising proceeded ahead of them, and it stopped over the place where the child was. The sight of the star filled them with great joy, and when they entered the house, they beheld the child with Mary, his mother. Falling to their knees, they paid him homage. Then, when they opened their treasure chests and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you. child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap, is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthem sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to all. King of kings, salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. Praise, praise a song on high. The virgin sings her lullaby. The babe, the Son of Mary. The babe, the Son of Mary. The babe, the Son of Mary.
Thank you. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place for you. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only Son was born. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
The shepherds left the flock by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed.
The star shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. The wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place at which you were, the this baby boy would grow to be.
One day a diamond would die for me and you.
My sins would drive the nails in you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, our Savior, is born. Everyone, please stand.